It's chat. I'm kind of used to it now. Like every photo I post on my Instagram is like three pieces of soda, but I laugh it off. It's a bit funny to me, but it is what it is. His day will come, and when it comes out, I'll spank him whenever I'll see him. Wherever I'll see him, it's going to be a fight, so his day will come.
Have we any news yet? I mean, everybody in the UK wants to know, have you got this top-ranked opponent everybody wants to see against? Do you feel like it's going to happen this time, and have you heard anything yet?
Hopefully, because I ain't fighting otherwise. So I am pushing for RDA, and I feel hopefully in September or August that they should offer that fight, so we'll see. So far I'm hearing that we're edging that way, so we'll wait and see.
And you're refusing to take any fights this time? It's like nearly a protest. If they don't give you an opponent in that top five, you're just not going to fight?
I feel so. What more do I need to do? I've beaten everyone they gave me. I've never turned down a fight. I'm in seven fight win streak in one of the hardest division in the whole sport, you know what I mean? So I feel it's time to make a stance now, and I want my career to get to. I want to be a world champion, so I don't keep fighting every month and not getting nowhere in my career. So I feel top five, or I'm chilling.
You mentioned in the Q&A, you said Tyron Woodley as well as a name as a possibility. Why him, and what do you think that was in your career?
He's a former world champion. He just lost the belt to Usman. That's the last person to beat me, and I feel going out there and beating Tyron Woodley, that put me right, like I said, to be in the title shot. So that's the only reason, really. He's a former world champion. He's considered one of the best welterweights of all time. So that's the only reason I want to fight him. And plus, he beat Darren Till, so I'll go out and beat him, spank him, and settle that argument.
Is the Till fight still one of your
takes? Nah. Only way I'll take Till is probably if they offer me in Birmingham. Apart from that, it makes no sense. He's on a two-fight losing streak, been stopped twice in a row. I'm on a totally different path from what he's on, so unless it's in my hometown, Birmingham, then I'll fight anybody in Birmingham. But apart from that, it's not on my radar at the moment. I want RDA, Woodley, anyone top five to get me to the world title.
You've always been a pretty respected fighter, but you know, we see a lot of developments in the sport, people talking a lot, getting shot. Look at Colby Covington, his success. Yeah.
Look at Ben Askren. He's one of the worst fighters.
But they're getting big fights. We're getting the things they want.
Yeah, exactly.
That makes you perhaps reconsider. Maybe you should start speaking out a little bit.
I feel like as long as you're speaking facts, then it's all good. I'm speaking all facts. I'm showing my resume, and I'm speaking all facts. So if you're not speaking shit, then yeah. But if you just start being weird and just talking random stuff, then no.
Is that because you have kids, like you don't want them to look back and see you kind of talking smack and instigating stuff? Is that something you're conscious of, or is it just the way you are?
That's just where I am. Not to do with the kids or nothing, just that's the way I am. I think where I was brought up. To be fair, my brother is different. He talks a lot of smack, so I don't know.